Getting the Val1 error on Valorant? Here are 6 ways you can fix it. Before we move forward, do us a favor by subscribing to our channel and liking this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. Now, let's get started. Method 1. The first thing you can do is completely close the game and relaunch it. Right-click on the taskbar and select Task Manager. Look for any Valorant or Riot processes and right-click on them. Select End Task to close them. Now restart the game and see if the error persists. Method 2. The next thing you can do is disable full screen optimizations and run Valorant as administrator. Right-click on the taskbar and select Task Manager. In the Processes tab, look for Valorant or any Riot processes and right-click on them. Select End Task to close them. Now right-click on the Valorant desktop icon and select Open File Location. Click on Riot Games from the address bar. Next, open the Valorant folder. Open the Live folder. Next, open the Shooter folder and then open the Binaries folder. Open Win64 folder and look for the Valorant Win64 Shipping EXE file. Right-click on it and select Properties. Click on the Compatibility tab and check the Run this program as administrator box and disable full screen optimizations box. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Method 3. Another thing you can do is add the game to the antivirus exclusion list on your PC. If you have any third-party antivirus, then add the game to the whitelist or exclusion list. Those who are using Windows Defender, here is how you can do it. Type Windows Security in the search bar and select the top result. Select Virus and Threat Protection. Scroll down and click on Manage Ransomware Protection. Next, click on Allow an app through Controlled Folder Access and select Yes. Click on Add an Allowed App option. Select Browse All Apps. Browse to the Valorant installation folder and select the .exe file as earlier. Now check if you can launch it now. If you can't, then disable the Controlled Folder Access toggle from the previous window. Method 4. The next thing you can do is make sure the VGC service is running. Press the Windows plus R keys to open Run. Type services.msc and click on OK. Now look for the VGC service and double click on it. Change the startup type to automatic. Click on Start if it can be clicked, else click on Stop and then click on Start. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Now open Run again and type msconfig. Press Enter to open System Configuration window. Click on the Services tab and look for the VGC service listed here. Check the box next to the VGC service to enable it. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Method 5. Another thing you can do is update your graphics driver. If you're using an NVIDIA graphics card, you can use GeForce Experience to update the graphics drivers. If you don't have it installed, download and install it from NVIDIA's website first. Run GeForce Experience. After you open the app, click on Drivers and check if any new drivers are available. Download and install it. For AMD graphics cards, the process is similar but uses the Radeon software instead of GeForce Experience. Run the app and check for any available drivers. Download and install the latest drivers. Restart your PC. Method 6. The next thing you can try is reinstalling Vanguard. Open Run again and type appviz.cpl. Press Enter to open Programs and Features. Look for Vanguard and right-click on it. Select Uninstall and wait for it to finish uninstalling. Launch the game and it should automatically download and install Vanguard. Now check if the error is fixed. So that's it. Subscribe to our channel and get quick solutions to all your tech issues. Thanks for watching and always remember that we are here to help you out.